American West Football Conference. Apparently, that whole Tri-Cities thing got consolidated. I think it's like, I think they call it the Rush or something like that now. Yeah. So, five teams in the AWFC will be ready for the 2021 season in indoor football. Crazy stuff, right? Well, we found that on, you know, what was it, December the 31st or something like that, you know, that these are the 17 teams that are in the American Arena League this year. And, yeah, interesting stuff here, honestly. I don't even know where to begin because, I mean, I am so late on this. So, you know, I was thinking, like, yeah, what's going on here? So I checked today to see what in the world's going on, because I mean, I had noticed, you know, there was some things going on in the AAL, especially in the forums. Oh my god, the forums or something else, you know, there's now, I mean, there was a bash board for the AAL, now, you know, they're trying to clean it up on the forums and stuff like that on Facebook, but Facebook is hell, so, you know, there's really no reason for all that, but whatever. You have to bash on this league. You cannot think that it is legitimate. You cannot think that. Do not come in with that mindset now. Instead, we have a weird 17-team alignment for the 2021 season, if it even kicks off. So we got the Carolina Predators, got the Charlotte Thunder, got the Jersey Bearcats, the Mississippi Raiders. I know I said Raider the first time that I talked about this team. I don't even know if they're even going to play or not. They have an arena listed in Hattiesburg, Mississippi, but I don't even know if they're going to play or not, because we've never heard of them before. Did not think they would even exist. The Pennsylvania Union, Reading Raptors, and Tampa Bay Tornadoes. Yeah, the Tampa Bay Tornadoes are back in the AAL like we all expected. I mean, we kind of figured that out already. So a 7-team East Division. I don't know how that's going to work, but whatever. It makes absolutely no sense, to be completely honest with you. You got a couple of legit teams in the AAL, you know, like Western Michigan, you know, notwithstanding, you know, but there are some very few legit teams in the AAL, so we'll find out what's going on around here. So I did say that there was, yeah, the Chicago Power. Talking about the Midwest Division now. The Chicago Power, Indianapolis Enforcers, Music City Fire, St. Louis Bandits, as we expected it, and the West Michigan Ironmen in the Midwest Division now. There was some change in this Midwest Division. Apparently there was going to be plans for, you know, for all the Texas teams to be up in there, but now that's not happening, and they're in their own division now. So the North Texas Bulls have been added. You know, I did not think this team was even going to happen at first, but here they are. They're in this division. They are supposed to be in Fort Worth, technically. I don't know how that's going to work out. Again, you know, Fort Worth is not, it's definitely not a place to be holding games and stuff right now. I know that I saw a basketball game the other day that took place in Fort Worth. Was it a couple weeks ago? I think it was a couple weeks ago. Yeah, that took place in Fort Worth. That game had no fans there. It was just a bunch of cardboard cutouts. So Allen, the Tiger Cats, the Austin Wild, who are a travel team, because you can't have an AAL season without a travel team. The San Antonio Gunslingers. There's no San Antonio Valor, unfortunately. Don't know where those guys went. You know where those guys went? The San Antonio Valor? I don't know where they went. And the West Texas Buccaneers. Yeah. Yeah, still the same 17 teams. Not the same 17 teams. These are 17 teams in this league. Of course, you know, teams like the Carolina Cowboys and the Central Penn Chargers and the Maryland Eagles, South Florida Thunder, and Western Maryland Warriors aren't even on here, so not in the league. So wherever they could be, they might be dead. They might be still alive. Who knows? Find it out. Yeah, that's all I gotta say about this, you know, 17 AAL teams, five teams in the AWFC. And yeah, so the tier three leagues are looking like tier three leagues. Like, I don't even know what's happening. You know, I don't even know what's happening. Forget about that noise in the background. I don't even know what's happening. You know. But yeah, just wanted to make another video talking about these teams, because I mean, there's so much going on, you know, that you haven't really. I mean, there's been so much going on lately with other stuff that I haven't been able to focus on the arena stuff. So yeah, so there's that. You know, I'm curious as to how this is all going to work, because I mean, it looks like, you know, 17 teams isn't viable, especially with the weird looking divisions. You know, you got 7 in one division, 5 in one division, 5 in the other. I don't know how it's going to work out, but whatever. I guess this will work, I guess. You know. But yeah, that's all I got to say, you know, really. I don't know, what do y'all think? Cause, I mean, I don't know what's happening around here. Like, yeah, gets under the radar, does all this stuff. You know, we had a video out last month talking about this, and then, you know, they pulled up the rug under us, you know. So maybe some of these teams fold during the season or whatever, I don't know, but we'll find that out, you know, as we continue on trucking through winter and going on into spring. So we'll see, you know, what happens there. And until next time, until the next video, I'll see you guys later. Y'all have a good day.